Get that, folks. What we're doing is, Tom is going to say a few words on behalf of the people who committed suicide during the year as a result of the behaviour of receivers and people like George Maloney, and needs to be highlighted. After that, we're going to present the reading, which we intend to present to Mr. McGarry, or to Mr. Maloney, who hasn't turned up. So Mr. McGarry from Claytech Security has agreed to accept the reads on behalf of the people who committed suicide. And it's ironic because him and all his men there would also be big contributors to that suicide issue around the country. And as we can see, most of them are Eastern European, except for one Irish ex-army man.
Just watch the car behind you there.
Lads, mind the car, let in.
It's not a bus.
So,
Listen up, lads.
And all groups affiliated to anti-eviction to actually rage war against receivers and sheriffs who want to evict Irish families, contrary to the constitution of the state of this country. I would like to state that in the last 12 months, 450 families have been evicted from their homes. That's in excess of 1,400 children who are now homeless officially this Christmas. Now, I've stood over 37 suicide funerals, and it's the worst experience in the world. Irrespective of what the men behind me here consider they're standing for legitimately, the reality is that the banking inquiry has not concluded, and Garda Síochána have not concluded their investigations against criminal allegations against every financial institution of this state. And the four courts are issuing repossession orders without the people themselves having the proper representation, without their rights being identified, without the constitutional rights being identified. And as I say, going to a suicide funeral, if you're a father, if you're a mother, if you have nephews or nieces, and you see their lives destroyed, their futures destroyed, for the sake of capitalistic criminal banking institutions and security companies that are breaking the laws of this state. And I would like to state this publicly. Under the 1922 Courts Act, as the Garda Commissioner, as the Attorney General, and as the Minister for Justice has been notified, they have to be appointed, an under-sheriff has to be appointed by the ministerial appointment. That has not happened in this state. There is no under-sheriffs in Ireland. And currently, when Claytech Security or any security company arrive on a house, a farm, that are not appointed by the state, they're breaking the law. They're trespassing, which is a criminal act. They're breaking an entry, which is a criminal act. They're using intimidation under the Non-Fate Defences Against the Person Act, which is a criminal act. And I've asked the Garda Commissioner, I've asked the Minister for Justice and the Attorney General to ask his members to enforce the law. Receivers and Sheriff and Claytech Security who are at a person's home or farm or business illegally should be arrested. Again, I would ask publicly for the Attorney General to intervene. And finally,
before we
give this on behalf of all the souls who have taken their lives, and unfortunately in this area alone, I know of two individuals who took their life 24 hours apart, and it was never reported. More lives, more children's lives destroyed. The Land Conveyancing Law Reform Bill this week, within the Central Office, has lodged a constitutional challenge against the Land and Conveyancing Law Reform Bill. That's the bill that Claytech Security, the receivers, use to evict and appoint receivers. That's being constitutionally challenged. Under the constitution of this state, constitutional law supersedes civil law upon which today you're trying to act. Claytech Security and every receiver in Ireland will be superseded by constitutional law. The courts of this country should abide by the power of constitutionality. When this challenge is posted, your days are numbered until the Supreme Court of Ireland deem it to be valid or not. I would like to hand this reet to Mr. McGarry, who I personally consider has facilitated in contributing to the deaths of people across this country and the anguish and trauma and detriment to children and their childhoods. And I would love him to attend the funeral with me next Tuesday and watch the faces of three innocent children who had to watch their homes being taken and their father who put a rope around his neck to ensure he couldn't live with the shame. And there is a nice place. I do believe in an afterlife. And I will believe there will be a nice place for you, Mr. McGarry. They have a job to do. They've done it extremely well.
Well done, guys.
And thank you very much.
Come out for Jerry. Come out.
You should be ashamed.
Yes,
Mr. McGarry, one second. Mr. McGarry, you gave a commitment earlier this year to members of the Land League. This year that he would desist from this type of work. He has broken that. We're putting him on notice. He does work for pennies. We're going to visit every penny shop that he works in and put them under notice that Mr. McGarry is contributing to suicides in this country. He has breached the agreement he entered into, and shame on you.
Why did you
shame
breach the agreement?
Say two words.
There is no eviction.
Sorry, there's an eviction down in Carlow. That's what has us in Castledermot. Yes, there is an eviction.
There is.
And tomorrow morning, Mr. Maloney is going to the Irish courts to confirm a Christmas wish.
We're not going to evict people.
It's not an eviction.
What is it?
No,
what would you call it? What's best? The farm is in the middle. The house
as
is in the middle of a family farm.
The inspector, don't let the truth get in the way of the
You tell the truth.
The
truth is, George Maloney is not evicting anyone from any house.
Okay. He's evicting a farm. He's taken a farm.
That's a house.
A farm
is
he's taken. And Mr. McGarry.
And ordinarily a family resides.
No.
The farm. Sorry, Mr. McGarry.
Never has resided in that property.
Mr. McGarry, you have been down. The house is in the middle of
any. Never resided in that property.
The farm is it. The house is in the middle of 80 acres. You're taking the farm around the man's house.
The house is not.
It's a family farm, Mr. McGarry, and if you don't, you broke the law. You broke the law, McGarry.